Steve Dotto here. How the heck are you this fine day? Me? I'm feeling particularly well. Thank you very much for inquiring. Today, I want to take on what I consider to be a fairly important topic. We have this need now to be engaged in the world of social media, but oh my goodness, it is a time vampire like nothing we've ever experienced. Checking Facebook, checking Twitter, checking LinkedIn, checking YouTube, all of the different social media channels that we have to work with, if we want to be effective communicators in our lives today, tend to overwhelm us. Oh, I left out Google Plus. How could I leave out Google Plus? I'm going to show you how I overcome the overload that is social media management. And I'm going to do it using Hootsuite, which is a social media dashboard. Take a few minutes with me, stick around, learn. You are going to love this demo today on Dotto Tech. If you're anything like me, you have something of a love-hate relationship with the entire world of social media. While you love the opportunity to communicate, how much it engages us with our audience, with our family, with our friends, you're also probably increasingly frustrated with the amount of energy that it sucks out of your day, the amount of time that it takes away and productivity that it takes away, not just from you, but from your employees, from your loved ones, from everybody around you. We just seem to be consumed by social media. Well, I don't think that that's going to go away anytime soon, so I'm looking for the best tools that I can to mitigate the amount of damage caused. I want to leverage the time that I spend in social media, have tools that make me far productive in the time that I do spend in social media. And for me, the base of a great social media system is Hootsuite. It's a dashboard, a social media dashboard that allows me to combine all of the different feeds coming from all of my different social media platforms, from Twitter, from LinkedIn, from Facebook. It allows me to bring all of the information into one place and also to distribute to those platforms from a single place. So I don't have to open each of those apps each time that I want to communicate in that space. Now, if looking at the screen and hearing what I just said about a social media dashboard makes your eyes spin back in your head because you don't quite understand what I'm talking about, I recommend you stop watching this video right now and instead watch the video that I'm posting over my shoulder. That video is all about, that's an introductory video to Hootsuite and social media dashboards. It'll be worth you taking 10 minutes following that one through. It'll give you a good understanding of what a social media dashboard is before we move ahead. If you are still with me and you understand what a social media dashboard is, let's move into how Hootsuite can really, how it will basically improve your productivity and your communications capabilities while you are in social media. So for me, Hootsuite is a daily visit. Every morning when I'm doing, after I've done my email and I, in my own routine, I open up Hootsuite and I prepackage all of the different marketing type posts that I'm going to send that day. Now, this isn't for the conversational stuff. Conversational stuff goes on through the day because you have to wait for a reply before you can have a conversation. But this is for the marketing type messages, to promote videos that I've just produced, to promote and let people know about upcoming courses and encourage them to sign up for webinars that I deliver, that sort of stuff. On a daily basis, I want to use all of my different social media platforms to encourage and to build my market and my brand. Now, if I was to go into Twitter and post several times a day, and to go into Facebook and post several times a day, every time I go in, that's a huge time commitment. I mean, you think about changing what you're doing, launching the application, logging in, composing the post, posting the post. It's a lot of work. Instead, because so often the messaging is similar, what I'm going to be posting in Google Plus is so similar to what I want to post on Facebook, it's much more efficient for me to do it all at once, and I do it right from within Hootsuite. Now, if we take a look at my Hootsuite feeds here, you probably recognize what they represent. I've got a Twitter feed here of my home feed, which is all the information coming in. This is all of the different mentions, times that I mentioned, so that I can monitor my brand as I'm going. And this is where, through the day, I'll often check the mentions within Hootsuite to make sure that I'm on top of any conversations that I should be having. Ah, but here's where Hootsuite starts to show a little bit of its magic. The notes field. I've integrated Hootsuite with my Evernote application, so I can actually go in and I can see my notes that I've got within my Evernote notebook right here within Hootsuite. And I use this in a few creative ways. Actually, I even tweet out and post out some of my notes as social media assets. I can actually share them directly. I can do that with my newsletter and other things. It's a very cool way of using Hootsuite, but it's for another video, that story. I also have all the direct messages here from within Twitter. And if you look into the top left-hand side of each of these streams, it tells you what social media platform or what tool is being used. So here at Twitter, some people use direct messaging within Twitter as a replacement for texting or as a replacement for email, especially reaching out in introductions and that sort of stuff. So there's all my direct messages there. And I also have YouTube integrated. Oh, this is where it becomes a bit of magic for Dotto Tech, because my main publishing platform is YouTube. I'm able to integrate my YouTube feed right here within Twitter. I mean, within Hootsuite, which means that I can take any assets within here and I can send them out to my social media network without going back and forth and copying and pasting URLs from within YouTube into the other applications. And I'll show you all that in a second, because where we do all of this communication is from this little dialog box up here at the top. This is where we compose different messages. And in the left side of that are all of the different social networks that I have, or accounts that I have attached to my Hootsuite account. So if I'm going to create a new quick post that I say want to send to everybody in my network, say I want to promote the a video that I've just produced, or remind people of a video. Here I'm going to post one about Facebook privacy settings. It's a very popular one. So there's the text that I want to add to it. But what I want to do is I actually want to tie that to a video. I want to promote a video. So if I scroll down here in my videos, these are all my most recently produced videos. And right here, where is it? It's down here somewhere. Show more. It's a little bit farther down. There it is. Facebook privacy settings. This is awesome. See these tools at the top? These are sharing tools just like we have everywhere in the rest of Hootsuite. So if I click here to share this, it automatically generates a post with the title of the video at the heart of the post. Now all I do is I type in the rest of the text that I want, which is the little promo that I have. Are you on top of your Facebook privacy settings? Probably not. This is something that I want to share right now to all of my networks. Now, the way I use this on a day, I'm going to share this right now so that you can see the sharing, you can see how it instantly does it and how we leverage into the multiple networks. But typically speaking, I would not post this right at this moment. Instead, what I would do is I would use this scheduling tool, which gives me a whole bunch of different options. I can manually choose a time and a day for this post to go forward. So this is what I do in the morning, is I compose all of my posts, and through the day, I schedule when I want those posts to go out. So if I've got a new live show that evening, I'll be saying, I'll post for an hour before, I'll write the post in the morning, 1 hour to go till the new show is on the air. And then I'll post that for 6 o'clock because the show airs at 7. And at 5 o'clock, I'll create another post that says, don't forget, 2 hours from now, a new live show is airing. So I can pre-create all of the posts that are going to be going out in all of these different social platforms. And I can do that first thing in the morning, get it out of the way. I can do it once a week and get it out of the way for the whole week or for the whole month if you happen to be that much in control of these sorts of promotional posts that you can create. You can also, if it's a little less time sensitive when it is being posted, use the auto schedule feature, which will automatically slot your posts in through the day. And you can give it an hour period that you want the post to go out. If you just want them to go through the business day or you just want the evening, whatever you want, you can set up preferences as far as when the posts are going to go. And then in the scheduling tool within Hootsuite, you can actually go in and you can create a spreadsheet if you really bulk post. If you've got hundreds of posts that go up because you deal with large volumes of posting, you can actually set up with a spreadsheet that has all of your posts, upload them in bulk, and have them batch processed that way. But that's beyond my ken. It's not something that I do. But you have the ability to do that as well. So we have all of these. This is, to me, the feature within Hootsuite that makes it worth using. All of the different streams, being able to see all of your different information, very valuable, but this is the killer app. This is the one that makes it work in my life, because now I can spend 20 minutes in the morning and I can pre-plan all of my scheduled posts for the day. And to the audience, it looks like I'm active in social media all day long. I'm reaching out to people throughout the day when they might be there to be able to access it. And I wouldn't have time through the day to think about it at 10 o'clock in the morning. I should send another post. No, it's going to be done for me. And how effective is it? Watch this. I've got one post that's ready to go. It tells me within here how many characters I have left in Twitter. I can add 17 more characters. If this is just a Facebook only post, I can still write a book. And if this is a LinkedIn post, I can add this many more characters. And Google Plus, it doesn't have quite as great an integration with Google Plus, but it will post to Google Plus, as I will show you in just a moment. And instead of scheduling it, I am going to go and I'm going to cancel that. Oh, there we go. I'm going to just close down that. Remove the scheduling and send now. There it is. Send now. Are you ready? Send. All right. So I've just sent out this post. It'll give me a confirmation message. Message posted. Shall we look and see if we were successful? Let's go into my Twitter account. Let's take a look at my feed. And there's my new feed. There's the new post right there. That's one with the YouTube video attached so people can watch the video right away, which is what I want. Isn't that awesome? Oh, it gets better. Let's go to my LinkedIn feed. And let's LinkedIn. Let's update my LinkedIn. And there's my post into LinkedIn. Oh, next one. Let's go into Facebook. Let's refresh my Facebook feed for my Dotto Tech brand. And there's the same post in Facebook. One click of the mouse and I reached three different networks with the same basic content, and I can schedule it into the future. To me, that is what makes Hootsuite a must-have tool. Let me just jump back into Hootsuite for a moment and show you where we can go in. If you need to make changes, if you are scheduling, this is the schedule or the publisher, it's called. I said schedule earlier, it's called publisher. This is where I see all of my pre-done posts all ready to go through today and actually through the rest of the week. So most of these ones through the rest of the week, I have a webinar coming up. So I just wanted to create an ongoing, not overwhelm my marketplace. You can see I'm just posting once a day, and I could probably post more than once a day. Certainly into things like Twitter, you can post more than once a day with the same idea because it just goes by so fast that people miss it. But I've just set that up so that I've got this continual presence in social media. Oh, wait a minute, Steve's got a webinar coming up. You know, you might see it in Facebook, you might see it in Twitter. Once you've seen it a couple times, it might trigger you, I should probably take that in. So I'm not just looking for a single home run, having you watch my video or sign up for my webinar the first time you see it. I'm making sure that I reach across all of my different social platforms and reach out to you with it. And as I say, Hootsuite to me is the tool that makes it work. We can attach all of our different social platforms, all of our different feeds to it. Now, it does far more than this. I'm just touching on one aspect of using Hootsuite, and that aspect is the sharing. It's also great for doing research. Oh, I should, before I finish, jump across and show you. I showed you two different apps that I've integrated within Facebook, or within Hootsuite. My Evernote app and my YouTube channel. You do all of that through the app directory. Some of these are paid, some of them are free, but these tools just, they really change how Hootsuite works for all of us. It becomes far more than just social media feed. At that point there, it gives us the ability to integrate all of these other different tools within Hootsuite, and you'll find different ways to integrate them. I could do a whole series of videos just on the ways to integrate these tools. Oh, look at that. They've got a new Trello app. That's one that I hadn't seen yet. I'll have to take a look at that one. So as you can see, there are lots, and they're always changing the number of different tools. Oh, there I am being able to post to Instagram using it, which is you can integrate MailChimp. It goes on and gets better and better. I hope that I've opened your eyes in this video to a way to use Hootsuite to leverage and to save you time on a daily basis in social media. And I want to remind you that there are three different ways that you can stay in touch with us if you want to see more of our videos. The first way is please subscribe to our channel. I would love to, if you joined our rank of subscribers, we're on a mission to get to 100,000 subscribers by the end of the year. I don't think I'm going to make it to 100,000, but if you sign up as a subscriber, I'll be that one subscriber closer. Also, I encourage you to sign up for our newsletter. We post new videos every week, and I send out one email each week, which is a digest of all of the new videos, but also lets you know about any special events that I have coming up, like webinars or different courses that we are offering that might be of interest to you. And finally, this Dotto Tech channel is actually supported by you, by the patrons that view us on an ongoing basis. And we use a crowdfunding site called Patreon, which means that I don't have to go out and seek corporate funding, but instead we ask our viewers to spend a little bit of money and help support our channel. For as little as a dollar a month, you can become one of our Patreon supporters and ensure that this steady stream of content from Dotto Tech continues unabated. And with that, I am done for the day. Have fun storming a castle.